For generations, Julia Child taught modern kitchen techniques to millions on TV. Here she is in her PBS show, The French Chef, demonstrating how to make beef stew.
Because you want the flavor of the onions and the beef to all blend themselves with the stew.
That was then.
Oh, I can't believe it's in the picture.
But this is now. Chef Joshua Wiggum is on the cutting edge of modernist cuisine at the Bazaar restaurant in Los Angeles and is one of many chefs experimenting with new ways to cook.
So now here we have what's called a liquid olive.
The taste, just like, you can never forget it. Also, the way it's presented, it's such a different and unique look to it.
Liquid olives? How about steak cooked in a bath or juice made in a centrifuge? Let's have a look at cooking equipment 2.0.
The centrifuge has been around forever. It's only in the past 15 years where more people are pushing the envelope. Wow.
There's no doubt New York has great food. But here in Chinatown, the real culinary advances come from the lab, not the kitchen. Dave Arnold is a chef. Kent Kirschenbaum is a chemistry professor at NYU. And together,
fire!
They make stuff happen. How does a collaboration between a chemist and a chef, how does that happen?
Well, I think one of the misperceptions about scientists and chefs working together is that we always want to create something bizarre, strange, and kind of scary.
We literally raided Kent's lab, and we're like, we haven't used that yet, let's use it. There are chefs all over the country kind of doing that. Once we bring it into the kitchen, it's now a piece of cooking equipment.
I'm a biologist. I've spent a lot of time in a lab, but this has got to be one of the coolest labs I've ever been in.
You know, we have all the cookbooks we need, chemistry books, liquor, food, and then a battery of things that look like scientific equipment, like immersion circulators. We're just gonna put a light initial sear on it.
Okay.
The most important cooking revolution of the past 200 years has been the move towards low temperature cooking, like without question. Hmm. This is where the science meets the cooking. Scientists had a way to accurately control temperatures, very accurately, because they needed it, right?
Yeah.
And cooks, all we ever wanna do is be consistent. And then we realized that you can achieve textures and results that you couldn't otherwise achieve. And so now, all these great chefs are buying into this low temperature cooking.
Nicely done, Deb.
Put a little bit of olive oil.
Okay.
I'll take the less.
That's really good. We're about to go in and watch Dave Arnold mix up a few drinks, but he won't be using any conventional kitchen utensils. Let's just say it might be good to have a fire extinguisher nearby.
I developed this tool, which is a modern red hot poker, which functions a lot like the one in the fireplace. And you put it in, and it heats and ignites the drink. It's about 1650 degrees Fahrenheit. And the super high heat really changes the composition of some of the flavor molecules in the liquor, especially sugars.
Wow, that is really good. It's got some citrus and that real anise flavor. Chefs like Dave are also mixing up drinks in unusual ways with unlikely ingredients. This drink is made by pulverizing lettuce with liquid nitrogen. Right, so you're just muddling that down.
Yeah, but look at how finely powdered it is.
Oh, wow.
I mean, you can never get like that kind of thing with normal muddling.
It literally is powdered lettuce.
Yeah.
You can't even tell it's lettuce at all.
Whether or not you are cooking over a campfire or whether or not you are using liquid nitrogen, it does not matter. Understanding the science and treating cooking like an experiment, in other words, observing what's going on and trying to take note of what's happening and understand, that is important no matter what kind of cooking you do. And that's happening now.
Only
only on Al Jazeera America.
A team of scientists are taking their inspiration from nature.
Technology, it's a vital part of who we are.
They had some dynamic fire behavior.
And what we do.
Transcranial direct stimulation. Don't try this at home.
TechKnow's team of experts show you how the miracles of science.
This is my selfie. What can you tell me about my future?
Can affect and surprise us.
Sharks like affection.
Catch new episodes of TechKnow on Al Jazeera America. Check your local listings or visit aljazeera.com.